I get this?
Just relax.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
As soon as you take over.
Because for real, it won't plug in.
And then, sorry. Oh, that's Cameron's.
Oh, I've got mine here.
Here we go. Good.
This is a farce.
There we go.
Okay.
Okay, right.
Next question.
Wait, now I'm forgetting how to spell.
Lockwood.
Lockwood.
My favourite Netflix show.
Lockwood & Co.
Lockwood & Co. A taxi for Lockwood & Co. Kind of flashbacks because
are we
driving? We're near Bank Studios.
Are we actually? Oh my god, it's actually down there, isn't it?
Oh, it's down the little road, isn't it?
Oh my god, I remember being dropped off there like so many times.
I remember meeting Scarlett there. I remember leaving Bank Studios on like the fourth day of auditions.
Yeah.
And Scarlett walking me out, and I was like, right, I think I've got to go back home now. And she was like, Do you want to come back tomorrow? And I was just like, okay, yeah, sure. I was like, is that a good thing? And she went, I think so.
So Scarlett is one of the producer's assistants.
Yeah.
And Bank Studios is where we had most of our early auditions.
Carmel Cochran, yeah.
Where we first met.
So we met first.
Yeah, we met first in Shepperton.
In
Studios.
Shepperton, doing like a screening test.
Yeah.
But you guys were like already thick as thieves by the time I met you.
We weren't. We were just, putting on an act in front of you.
trying to make me feel left out.
But I'm loving the funny looks we're getting.
Oh, people
what
driving
the hell
up.
Is going on in there?
Just like all six of us squished into the back of the cab. Hello.
I gave his way back.
No, that was
he
it.
He was really good. Yeah. He took five takes. Yeah. Five, not a double date, was it?
So when Ruby was filming her scenes, you guys were watching Harry Potter together.
We were.
Yeah, we were working hard.
We watched all, I mean, not all on set, but we got through all of them. We watched all of them.
No, I
am the Half-Blood Prince.
What's your favourite Potter film?
The one with Jeffy.
Yeah, Goblet of Fire.
Jeff's amazing.
I mean, let's just talk about Jeff. I hope he doesn't mind me saying he's probably, I think he's our oldest member of cast. But he.
What? That's an unnecessary thing to say.
Okay, cut that.
Yeah.
Wildly
unnecessary.
You know, you should have seen where I was going with it. Because I was going to say.
I don't see the vision.
No, hear it.
I just see criticism.
Let him cook.
I hope Jeff doesn't mind me saying
that. Masked insult was like.
He brought, I think, out of all of us, he brought the most energy on the night shoots. And every single take, he would do it differently.
Yeah.
And
Mr. Lockman?
Someone had to do was apply themselves. Wasn't too difficult, was it? Good work, Mr. Lockwood. If you come with me, sign a few forms, I can release payments.
Perfect.
Is this Hyde Park?
Oh my god.
We filmed.
This probably isn't even in the plan.
No, yeah.
But we actually filmed here.
We filmed on like the. Yeah.
And there were so many people.
There was a lot of people.
Lining up, and there were so many Netflix people walking up to them going, would you mind just putting your phone down and not filming, please?
That was a tricky night. I remember it being quite, like, particularly cold. He kind of, you know, pushes it too far, she's like, I'm leaving, and then he's like, don't leave, like, you know, and then he draws her back in, and actually you kind of see that they're two, like, lost souls that find each
it's
other,
it's a really nice
know?
Scene. It's yeah. always one of my favourites.
Because we're nobodies.
No, we're not. We're Lockwood & Co. You, me, and George.
But no, I mean, one thing about night shoots that I'm sure these two were too modest to mention is that there's one scene at the end of episode 7, these two have to climb out of the Thames, and they were doing this at the peak of winter in February.
I forgot about that.
So they were climbing out of the ice cold Thames, soaking wet, onto a bank.
No, our stunt doubles, Ellie and Troy, they were the courageous souls that like got in, you know, and then crawled out the Thames, and then me and Cameron kind of got doused in water at like 1 a.m. and then were like lying down in the pebbles kind of
Thames.
Like gritting every teeth just to like, because it was cold, it was really cold.
It was a bit cold.
I remember like makeup being like, okay, I'm just gonna like put the water on now, and I was like, do it. You were drinking loads of gravy as well.
You went through the gravy phase.
Yeah.
You'd just be like, oh, does anyone have any bisto?
I said to Ezra, one of the ADs once, I just in passing, I don't know if I said it to him or under my breath or something, but I think we were just sort of waffling to each other, and I just went, oh, I'd kill for some Bisto right now. And then, like, 20 minutes later, you know, Agent Ezra turned up again, and he just had it, and I was like, where have you got that from? And he was like, I ran to Tesco. It's like, Ezra, oh my God,
such a legend.
What a legend. And I was like, and then, and now he tells the story that I asked him to go to Tesco and get me going to piss me off.
Yeah, yeah.
And do you think you went for Bisto because you're so sick of tea filming?
No, I could never be sick of tea.
Cameron never gets sick of tea.
I could never be sick of tea.
Very long night. Please tell me this tea.
I've heard a rumour that you have a very specific form of tea that you like.
You heard correctly.
Can we do a big showcase reveal of the tea?
Welcome back to the Ali Hadji-Heshmati and Ruby Stokes cooking show.
On how to make the Cameron special. We're here with a cup and we have...
An English breakfast.
And then we take some runny honey, you know, one squeeze on the tea bag. So we take one spoonful of white sugar.
Yes.
In the bag. Then...
Hot water.
Yeah.
And then we add...
No.
Oh.
We let it sit. We let that sit.
Okay.
And stew.
Stew.
Correct?
Yes, to brew.
To brew.
Yeah.
Not stew.
Not stew.
And then we pick it back up. We remove said tea bag.
No, I think we keep it in.
Oh, we...
Expert.
Oh my God,
phone
we keep
friend,
it in.
Keep the tea
phone a friend, in. We keep okay. it in.
And then you add a bit of semi-skimmed milk.
Ah, oh, finally.
It just became like this cult thing on set of like, shorthand of like, can I have a Cameron special? Because, you know, you don't
It was not a cult that. Thing, nobody else was drinking it.
No, people were asking about it. They weren't asking you because you don't know.
I do know now.
Yeah, now you do.
I'm clearly the one in here who can make a Cameron special.
You wanted to take the tea bag out.
No. We were busy having hot chocolates.
You got anything from her?
Haven't tried. Been too busy trying to make contact with the living.
Why not have a go before she gets any closer?
Can we do an official Lockwood biscuit ranking?
Okay.
So I'm going to give you 4 biscuits.
Okay.
Like a tier list.
I'm really passionate about this. Okay, before you even say any biscuit. So, no, actually, no.
You go. You've got to jump in there.
What is it?
Okay, so... I think the Jammy Dodger is the best biscuit by a country mile because...
Custard cream.
I could
first.
Chocolate bourbon.
So Jammy Dodger's my in your
Dodger.
Top two.
You know tiny little Jammy Dodgers?
I do.
They're the best because they've got like the right ratio of biscuit to jam.
Dipping biscuits in tea.
Essential.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely.
I thought I look quite rabbity every time I've seen that bit in episode one where I go like, wait, I really stick my teeth out.
I love the sound.
I like go, dup, 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 dup,
sound,
like that.
The sound when Lucy's...
Oh, wait.
At Ealing Studios.
Yeah.
At Ealing Studios, which is the studios we were filming in, there is actually a ghost, apparently. There is one...
No way.
No, I know. Apparently, there is one stage that's haunted.
Well, there's only two stages. So it's one
B stage, then? I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know which one. I hope they're not the one
we're
that we
say, it's one of the oldest studios in the world.
Is it?
Yeah.
Wow.
I think, and don't take me on this, but I think actually the term green room came from Ealing Studios.
Did it actually?
Because of the green. Because of the green park.
I think it's Warple Park behind it, yeah.
That is so cool.
I hope someone fact checks that. We're about to go to Ealing Studio, aren't we?
No, we are. We're going to rock up and then go, get out, it's time to work.
So in Ealing Studios, we had Portland Row, the whole of Portland Row.
Oh my God.
Oh, we're not going to go all the way down.
No, it's probably someone else.
And we're saying bye, yeah.
Damn, no, that's so sad. I think the set of Portland Row is so good.
I spoke to Jonathan about it the other day.
Yeah.
The author of the books, and it was really nice hearing him talk about it.
Yeah,
talking about like stepping into his imagination, stepping
that
into
that must be
his,
surreal though.
Because I said to him, you know, surely it feels like these like young adults are like your family, they're like your creations. And he was talking about it like stepping into Portland Row was special because he felt like he was going to, you know, family members' house that you hadn't been to in a while? Or...
I remember, like, the first time I met Jonathan, I was like, I was so eager to kind of, you know his take on the world and what he thinks we've all done with it. And then I was like, oh, so, like, do I look like how you imagine Lucy? Like, I was like, so my last question for you.
He was so trusting. And that gives you a massive boost of confidence.
Sources are fascinating and illegal. Put those two things together and there's your black market.
A ruthless one at that.
We had a lot of taxi scenes in the show.
Yeah, as well. We had a couple of taxis.
I mean, especially we'd be like us three and a cameraman.
You're sat in the most uncomfortable seat right now because I had to sit in that one.
To Kensal Green.
Yeah, to Kensal Green.
And it was like us two and Andy.
Andy's up in here. And we had that one in Hyde Park as well. And they had like
we had this walkie-talkie in the truck with Will McGregor, the director. And all the sort of production team were in this van, this open van, a removals van, in front of us in the cab.
We were communicating with the taxi.
But they had this weird like sofa arrangement in there.
And it was with a red light, and it looked so seedy in there.
It looked like a strip club.
They were sat on the sofa. Yeah.
We were going on the radios. They were like, "How's Spearman?"
Yeah.
Lockwood, Netflix.
Now.
Run.
Thank you for watching A Taxi with Lockwood & Co.